Right then, so I've missed the first coat, but I've laid my first coat on. I've flattened it down twice, just waiting for it to go just a little bit, so you can just see your little fingerprints in it. And I've just mixed up my second coat. And this coat now is going on about 1 mil. So my first coat was put on about 2 mil, and then you put your final coat on, which is about 1 mil, and then you get a flat wall. So when I'm troweling it on, I'm almost finishing it off as I go. Just troweling it up as you go. The more work you put into your first coat, getting it flat, your second coat goes on so much easier. You use less material. So always make sure your first coat is bang on. Really, the second coat is more about trying to get the imperfections out of your first coat. So get it on really tight. Really work it down so you're flattening it and kind of troweling up as you go along. So again, just on the ceiling now, I flattened the ceiling down, give it a couple of flattens, made up a new mix, and now I'm putting my second coat on. I'm getting it as tight as I can. Oh, my mate Scott's ringing me from Australia. Oh, am I? Plastering, Scott. I'm making a video out of plaster. You have to ring me back in a bit, Scott.
gotta get out of this way. If it's the last thing I ever do.
So that's my second coat put on now. Next thing I do, because I've gone wet edges to wet edges, ceiling to walls, I just clean it up with the Nella Black Corner Edition 101 degrees. So that's that corner kind of worked in. So with that, you get the two lines coming from either side. So the reason why I do it white, wet, before I start troweling up, is so I can trowel that line back out. I know I need to get back down to where that line is to feather it back out. So I basically just run my trowel along. I always like to work my corners in really good. So as you can see, that's my first flattened down and the walls are looking pretty good. I can almost walk away from it now, but it's gonna have a couple more goes. So now I'm just gonna flatten the ceiling down again with a solid steel trowel. Now I'm just going to flatten the corners back in again with my corner trowel. That's looking pretty good. I'm going to come over here. So you kind of get that little line going along here from the wing of the corner trowel. But now you kind of feather that back out again with your steel trowel. So we're gonna dress the corner back up, just where the wings are of the corner trowel, and flatten it back down. Quite a lot of pressure now. It's all about compression. Make sure you get that corner in nice and tight, working that squim, making sure it's not going to come out over the next year or whatever. So that once you flatten it down on that stage, you've kind of got to leave there for another about 10-15 minutes. So I find I'll go and cook some pasta, you know, and just make a nice pasta dinner, like in the back of the van, like, you know. Like a curry pasta. Yeah, nice. So right through this set so far, I've not sprinkled any water on it. I've just let it do its thing. So if you work it through its own drying times, through its chemical set, there's no need to be splashing loads of water all over it. Because that's when you start getting misses and it's too smooth to glide over. It's better to have a wet trowel rather than throwing loads of water over it, I find, anyway. So it's a wet trowel with compression. So my next hit now will be using like a super flex, my Nerve super flex. The last two passes of this set now. So Nerve super flex. This is the Nella Superflex Mark II Gold Edition. So, a wet trowel now. No flicking water all over it or anything. And then I give it my first cross trowel. And to keep it uniform, I just go in one direction. I don't cut back here and across. Kind of get like lawnmower lines, like in your garden. So yeah, uniform, always go the same direction, well, I do. So you won't be getting anything off really. And to use a super flex, you don't use the edge. You use this, the center of the center of the trowel, and a lot of compression, and that's how you you close in the plaster off. Still clean. you put in anything off your plaster at this point, and you're getting any plaster on your trowel, it's too early to be using a Superflex. You know when like the customer don't ever bring like a coffee or drink or anything? They try fucking you off with some like pasta.
What's that?
Oh, oh lads!
Look at that! Look at tears right now! I'm famous now, I'm on TikTok.
You're going to be on TikTok now. So this is about my final pass now. So I'm going to cross trowel, doing the ceiling. It's really like a dry trowel. It's pretty much good to go anyway, but just going to just put my mind at rest and just do one more pass. Cross trowel. Always clean your trowel as you go, so you've always got a clean blade go back on your next stroke. It saves dragging anything through your finish. So this is coming to the very end of it now, and so now we're just gonna clean off the bottoms just to make sure you keep the carton tears happy. So their skirting board fits nice and flush against the wall. And this is another thing, it's optional, obviously it's optional. We always clean the boxes out for the electric. It's totally optional because obviously like it's for an electrician. I'm gonna clean it out. I kind of like him, so yeah, I'm gonna clean it out because it's Brett. But apart from that, that is pretty much how you do a set. How I do a set. I'll just quickly take you around. So this is what we've done together. We've done it together. So we laid this ceiling on. We laid this wall on. We done this wall. And we done that wall. And that was the set. So I hope that helps, and thanks for watching.